InDesign is the best Adobe tool for creating traditional and expertly crafted typography. Designers often are quick to jump over to Illustrator or Photoshop if they want to create more unique and contemporary text effects. I'm Ashley Harrell, and in this tutorial, I will show you how to create 5 striking typography effects using tools and tricks available to you in InDesign. Before we begin, make sure you check out Envato Elements. Get unlimited downloads of design assets, templates, and fonts like the one used in this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe to Envato Tuts Plus for more free courses and tutorials. The first thing you want to do is create a new document. We will be using millimeters for the units, and for the width it should be 297, height should be 210, pages should be 5, and margins and the bleed should be the default. Now we're going to click on the swatches panel and we're going to add some new swatches. For the first swatch, change it to 100, 90, 10, and 67. And click on Add. For the next swatch, use 9, 100, 96, and 93. For the next color, use 0, 100, 100, and 17. And for the next color, use 0, 45, 100, and 0. Now for the background, we're going to fill it with the dark blue swatch that we created. Go to your layers panel and lock the background. Grab your type tool and type out your word. For this example, I will be using the word hot. Change it to the font you would like, and I'm changing my size to 210. And also center it as well. Change the fill to none and the stroke should be paper. Change the weight to 3. Now we're going to edit copy and edit paste in place. And on this layer, we're going to change the fill to the dark burgundy color. Move it over to the left and up. Now let's apply a drop shadow. Change the swatch to the red swatch. And the distance should be 6.35. And leave the rest as is. Now let's apply an outer glow. Change the mode to hard light. And the color should be orange. And change the opacity to 100%. Change the size to 9.525. Now let's add a basic feather. Change the feather width to 3.175 and the choke should be 23%. Now we're going to copy and paste in place this top layer, but we're going to get rid of the basic feather. Now highlight your text and apply a gradient from the red color to the yellow color. Now grab your type tool and we're going to type out each one of these letters individually. And make sure you fill it with black and then place it over each one of the letters. Now select one of your letters and go to Type, Create Outlines, and do this for the other letters as well. Select each one of those letters and fill them with none. Select the type tool and hover over the first character in the word. Click once on the square and click again in the next character to connect the two characters with text threads. You can go up to View, Extras, Show Text Threads to view how the characters are connected. Now I'm selecting my type tool here and I am using the font Dudek. Semi-bold round, the size is 9 and the leading is 9 as well. The orientation should be set to justify with last line aligned left. Click once inside the first character and go to Type, Fill with Placeholder Text. Now for this one, I am changing my font color to yellow. Now here I will apply a gradient feather and change the angle to negative 90 and click OK. Now I'm going to select my font layer again and edit, copy, and paste in place. Here I am turning off the outer glow and clicking on OK. I am highlighting my text and I am going to switch it over to the stroke. Change your stroke weight to 4. For this next effect, we will create a color block text effect. Let's go ahead and add some color swatches. For the first one, do 81, 18, 100, and 83. For the next color, do 32, 0, 63, and 0. For the next color, do 36, 0, 86, and 11. For the next color, do 60, 24, 100, and 11. Now do 50, 0, 100, and 58. And then click on Done. And for the background, we will fill it with the very first swatch that we created for this effect. Now go ahead and grab your type tool, and here I am just typing out my quote and arranging it. Now the next step, I am going to change the font to the Fullman, and I will be using various sizes. And for an added effect, I'm taking a couple of the words and I am slanting them to give it an added effect, and also applying some designs on the words as well. Now what you're going to do is we're going to grab 3 guides. So head on over to the left ruler and grab a guide and place it over your text. Here we're just creating columns of where we're going to color block our text. Do this 2 more times. Highlight your text in each one of these columns and select the swatches that we created previously. For our next effect, I will show you how to create a trendy style effect using the Type on a Path tool. Let's go down to page 3 of our InDesign document. The first color, let's do 69, 70, 0, and 0. For the next color, do 93, 99, 17, and 22. And then for this last color, I'm going to do a very light blue color. Now, of course, we're going to add a background color, and I will be using the deep purple color. Locking my background, of course. Now grab your type tool and type your word or your phrase. For this example, I will be using, if you look at what you have in life, you'll always have more. Now select your line tool and make a straight line by pressing shift on your keyboard. Now I am going to copy my first line of text and select the type on a path, click on the beginning of that line and edit paste. Or you can click on Command V on your keyboard. Now select your ellipse tool and create an oval. Select your scissors and we're going to cut each end so it's creating basically two halves. Now here I am going to copy and paste the top line and the bottom line so that it's on each of the half ovals. Now on this next step, I'm going to create new paths and move individual words or phrases onto them. I'm going to alternate the font size to create new arrangements like I'm doing on the screen. So here I am changing my font using Black Bear and Dudette. And here I'm just doing a lot more customizing. I'm choosing a different glyph and changing up the size of my font to give it a little bit more character. And then for the final step, you just have to select your swatches that we created earlier. And that is how you create a type on a path effect in InDesign. Now I'm going to show you how to make a drop cap effect. Grab your text tool and create a text frame and place it in the center of your document. Go up to type and fill with placeholder text. And here I'm just making some little adjustments. Now for this main text, I will be using the font Slylvania. And change your leading to 15 and also justify with last line aligned left. Select the very first letter. And we're going to change the drop cap to 10. And I will also change my font create a new swatch, and I'm going to use 0, 64, 0, and 52. Highlight the drop cap, and of course, change the color. And then go up to your baseline shift and change it to 48. Now go up to Window, Type and Tables, and then go to Story, and then make sure you click on the Optical Margin Alignment checkbox. And then add a texture background for a nice effect. Now I'm going to show you how to create a surreal twist to your typography. This is a cool contemporary effect that's more decorative than functional, but is really easy to create. Grab your line tool and make some diagonal lines. You can change your stroke to any color, but for this example, I will be using black. Now copy and paste this line and create several more. And now go over to your layers panel and change the first layer to guides and create a new layer and change this to typography. Now grab your type tool and type out some text. Change your font to Lorison. And here I am changing my fill to none, and my stroke will be 2. Using the lines as guides for positioning the text, repeatedly create new text frames and adjust their position on the page. Continue to create new text frames, inserting different text as you go. Now you can finish off your design by adding a black background and changing up your font colors. I decided to use black, white, and red. And that's how you make 5 typography effects in InDesign. So if you like this video and you would like to see more, go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe if you haven't already. And don't forget to click that little bell icon to be notified of any new videos. I'm Ashley Harrell. Thanks for watching.